Bollywood came together once again to support Twinkle Khanna as she launched yet another book. The best-selling author was joined by her actor husband Akshay Kumar and other celebrities as she unveiled her book Pyjamas Are Forgiving. Twinkle was also joined by actors Sonam Kapoor, Ranveer Singh and Bobby Deol and director Karan Johar. Her mother, Dimple Kapadia, also cheered for her daughter at the event held at the Taj Lands End, Mumbai. Mrs. Funny Bones, as Twinkle is known to her readers, wore a multicolored wrap dress with golden heels. Akshay turned up the soothing combo of white and pink and even held up a copy of the book for the cameras. Sonam showed off a brand new perm and wore a monotone outfit. Ranveer wore a cool green suit with a black hat. Amidst all the fun at the event, let's hear what will happen there at the star-studded evening of the book launch of Pyjamas Are Forgiving.
Well, two things. One, it fits the story because in that the protagonists are wearing pajamas throughout, right from the beginning to the end. The other one, because I think it's an allegory of life itself, where if you have pajamas and it's up to you to, find how tight you want to tie your drawstring or not. And I think by nature, sometimes we're too forgiving. Our drawstring is too loose, and then we end up without any pants on. So that is one thing. But the title came to me. It was, I remember a couple of years ago, it was Diwali. And after 2 weeks of drinking and eating and having lots of mithai and wearing Indian clothes, I was standing in front of my closet and trying on a pair of jeans, and they did not fit. And the line popped into my head that salwars are forgiving in nature. It's jeans that really know how to hold a grudge. And then I waddled off quickly and I wrote it down before I would forget. And it stayed with me, and finally it became the start. Right in the beginning, when I first started writing columns, one of my columns became very popular. And I called her up and I said, "Mom, you know, my column is really doing well. Have you read it?" And she said, "No, but I wanted to tell you over dinner last night that none of your serving dishes match." So I was so pissed off with her that I said, "What's the use of having you as a mother? I wish Hema Malini was my mother. At least I'd get a Kent water purifier free."
Yeah.
But on a serious note, when I look back and everything that I write about, it seems to be about women finding their place in the world, about the chafing between what a woman is and what she's meant to be. And she doesn't know this story, but I think somewhere it's because I have this singular image in my head. When we were little and we moved to our grandmother's house, we all had to share a room. So my mother and my aunt would share the bed, and my sister and me had mattresses on the floor. And every morning at 5, my mom would wake up. She would put on this Jane Fonda tape. She'd put it on mute, and she would do her workout all around it. And then she would go to work. At that time, they used to do 3 shifts. And she'd come home at 9. She never complained. She always had a smile. And for me, I think it was very clear at that point that a woman doesn't have to rely on anyone besides herself. And that men were okay. It was, enjoyable to have them like a dessert, but they were certainly not the main course. Mm. And
well, we differ, but anyway.
Yeah, well, yeah. I think for you also, their dessert, definitely not the main course. But having said that, I think that's pretty much defined my whole life, because I had this unique vantage point looking up from this mattress at this creature in a pink leotard with matching sweatbands. And she set the bar so high that I've spent my whole life reaching for it. So that's why this book and everything else I've written should be dedicated to her.